coming to you from our GIS studios. I am Anicia Antoine, and this is your Midday News Brief. The government of St. Lucia, in collaboration with the St. Lucia Social Development Fund, SSDF, launched the Maritime Training Program for the yachting sector. The program, which targets young men in Soufre, more commonly known as the Boat Boys, aims to build and expand the capacity of the Soufre Yacht Service Association, SISA, in order to generate financial benefits. The project was co-funded by the Government of St. Lucia and the Caribbean Development Bank via the Basic Needs Trust Fund. Some 45 persons are currently benefiting from the Maritime Training Program, which comes at an estimated cost of $125,000. Parliamentary Representative for Soufre, Honorable Harold Stanislas, commended the participants for recognizing the need to be a part of this initiative. The Maritime Training Program for the yachting sector was launched on Thursday, September 12, 2019. Realizing the changing tide towards the decriminalization and regulation of cannabis by regional and international counterparts, St. Lucia is intent on positioning itself to take advantage of the transformative economic benefits in the cannabis industry while simultaneously addressing human rights and public health issues. Cabinet, at its meeting held on the 29th of July 2019, approved the establishment of a commission to review and make recommendations on the regulatory framework for cannabis. The next steps for the commission in the next few months are to finalize operational activities and work plans, schedule meetings and consultations with national stakeholders, NGOs and the general public to gain insights on their sentiments and concerns and share the proposed approach on the establishment of a well-regulated cannabis industry in St. Lucia. The United States Naval Ship Comfort Medical Humanitarian Mission is expected to commence on Wednesday, September 25th to Monday, September 30th, 2019 in St. Lucia. Two walk-in clinics will be made available to the public and will be held at the Owen King EU Hospital and the National Cultural Center from 8 a.m. to 4 p.m. daily. Both walk-in clinics will offer the same package of services to clients, which include basic medical evaluation and treatment, dental screenings and treatments, eye screenings and provision of eyewear, skincare, internal medicine, children's health, women's health, and physical therapy. It is important to note that only surgical and diagnostic services like CT scans, ultrasounds, X-rays, blood, stool, and urine testing, and other related screening services will be provided on the USNS medical ship. Persons requiring surgeries and diagnostic services are asked to bring in a referral from the healthcare provider. This has been your Midday News Brief. Thank you for watching.